Good afternoon, Mr. President. My name is Ben Hershenson. I'm from Ogunquit, Maine, and also Bonita Springs, Florida. And I'm a Republican. I don't know what I'm doing here, but I'm here.
We're happy to have you. We're happy to have you.
Mr. President, you've been quoted over the years when you were a senator and perhaps even before then that you were essentially a supporter of a universal plan. I'm beginning to see that you're changing that. Do you honestly believe that? Because that is my concern. I'm on Medicare, but I still worry that if we go to a public option, period, that the private companies, the insurance companies, rather than competing, because who can compete with the government? The answer is nobody. So my question is, do you still, as yourself now, support a universal plan, or are you open to the private industry still being maintained?
Well, I think it's an excellent question, so I appreciate the chance to respond. First of all, I want to make a distinction between a universal plan versus a single-payer plan, because those are two different things. A single-payer plan would be a plan like Medicare for All or the kind of plan that they have in Canada, where basically government is the only person, is the only entity that pays for all health care. Everybody has a government-paid-for plan, even though, depending on which country, the doctors are still private or the hospitals might still be private. In some countries, the doctors work for the government and the hospitals are owned by the government, but the point is that government pays for everything, like Medicare for All. That is a single-payer plan. I have not said that I was a single-payer supporter because, frankly, we historically have had a employer-based system in this country with private insurers, and for us to transition to a system like that, I believe, would be too disruptive. So what would end up happening would be a lot of people who currently have employer-based health care would suddenly find themselves dropped, and they would have to go into an entirely new system that we had not been fully set up yet, and I would be concerned about the potential destructiveness of that kind of transition. All right? So I'm not promoting a single-payer plan. I am promoting a plan that will assure that every single person is able to get health insurance at an affordable price, and that if they have health insurance, they are getting a good deal from the insurance companies. That's what I'm fighting for. Now, the way we have approached it is that if you've got health care under a private plan, if your employer provides you health care or you buy your own health care and you're happy with it, you won't have to change. What we're saying is if you don't have health care, then you will be able to go to an exchange similar to the menu of options that I used to have as a member of Congress, and I can look and see what are these various private health care plans offering, what's a good deal, and I'll be able to buy insurance from that exchange, and because it's a big pool, I'll be able to drive down costs. I'll get a better deal than if I was trying to get health insurance on my own. This is true, by the way, for small businesses as well. A lot of small businesses, they end up paying a lot more than large businesses per person for health care because they've got no bargaining power. They've got no leverage. So we want small businesses to be able to buy into this big pool. Okay? Now, the only thing that I have said is that having a public option in that menu would provide competition for insurance companies to keep them honest. Now, I recognize, though, you raise a legitimate concern. People say, well, how can a private company compete against the government? And my answer is that if the private insurance companies are providing a good bargain, and if the public option has to be self-sustaining, meaning taxpayers aren't subsidizing it, but it has to run on charging premiums and providing good services and a good network of doctors, just like any other private insurer would do, then I think private insurers should be able to compete. They do it all the time. I mean, If you think about it, UPS and FedEx are doing just fine, right? No, they are. I mean, it's the post office that's always having problems. So, right now, you've got private insurers who are out there competing effectively, even though a lot of people get their care through Medicare or Medicaid or VA. So, there's nothing inevitable about this somehow destroying the private marketplace, as long as, and this is a legitimate point that you're raising, that it's not set up where the government is basically being subsidized by the taxpayers so that even if they're not providing a good deal, we keep on having to pony out more and more money. And I've already said that can't be the way the public option is set up. It has to be self-sustaining. Does that answer your question? Okay. Thank you.